So in the previous class, we had discussed about the natural resource, which is categorized into two categories, that is renewable sources and non-renewable sources. So water is one of the renewable sources. Even if we are using the water, it comes back to earth in the form of rains. So it is a renewable resource. But we should use water in a limited way. We should not waste water. About 70% of the earth's surface is covered with the water. So water is found everywhere in oceans, seas, rivers, ponds, streams, snow and underground. So water is present in air also in the form of water vapor. So about 70% of the earth's surface is covered with the water in various forms. So there is abundance of water on earth. 70% of earth's surface is covered with the water, but very little amount is available to us, because out of this large amount is present as glaciers and ice caps, and less than 1% is available to us from different sources like lakes, ponds, rivers, groundwater. So we are using all the in our all the activities day to day life, we need water. So for all these, very little water is available to us. So if we will see the distribution of water, then we can see that if we will consider all water, whatever water is present in the form of ocean, sea, river, ponds or underground water, if we will consider them 100%, then out of 100%, 97% is our salt water, and only 3% is fresh water. So you can see here 97% is found in the oceans and fresh water is only 3%. So if we now we will distribute the fresh water, then among the fresh water is glaciers and ice caps, they constitute 79%. And our groundwater, they constitute 20%. So only 1% is present for us. So accessible surface fresh water is only 1%. So first of all, out of 100%, 97% water was in the oceans, and the 3% water we are getting as fresh water, which is again, if we will divide the 3% fresh water, then out of this 3%, 79% is found in ice caps and glaciers, 20% is found in the groundwater, and only 1% is available to us. That means accessible surface fresh water is only 1%. So now if you will see the accessible surface fresh water, then out of that 1%, lakes are having 52% water. So lakes constitute 52% water, and the living organisms, those who are living in water, water within living organisms, that is 1%. Soil moisture contains 38%, water vapor is 8%, and rivers contains 1%. So this is our accessible surface water. So if we will distribute the water, it will come in this way. First of all, 97% is found in the oceans and 3% in the fresh water. Among the fresh water, again it is categorized into glaciers and ice caps, groundwater, then accessible surface fresh water, that is only 1%. Again, if we will categorize the accessible surface fresh water, then we can get that lakes are having 52%, rivers 1%, water vapor 8%. So this is our distribution of world's water. So now we will see the properties of water, and if we will see the properties, then we know that we are having three states of matter: solid, liquid and gas. And water is the only substance which we can easily see in all the three states. So water is available in all the three states of matter, that is solid, liquid and gas. So the freezing point of water is 0 degrees Celsius, it is present as ice, and boiling point of water is 100 degrees Celsius, and it is also present in the form of water vapor. So water is the only substance which we can see easily in all the three states, and the temperatures are easily attainable. So the freezing point and boiling point of water, these temperatures, they are easily attainable, and water can easily change into all the three states. Means it can change from solid to liquid and liquid to gas or gas to liquid. So it can change into all the three states. It gets replenished in nature by water cycle. So the water circulates on the earth in the form of water cycle. The continuous movement of water on the earth, or the cyclic movement of water on the earth, that is called water cycle. So here you can see clearly water cycle. So suppose we will start from here. This is our fresh water storage. This is water storage in oceans. Surface runoff. So water is present in the surface. Ground water is present. So all these waters are getting evaporated. Evaporation takes place. That means the waters are getting converted to vapor. Fresh water storage or in the oceans, all these waters are getting evaporated. Even the plants are losing water. That is called transpiration. So plants are also losing the water in the form of transpiration. Even the snow or ice caps or glaciers, they are undergoing sublimation. Sublimation is a process where the solid changes directly to gases form without coming to the liquid state. So here solid ice is directly converted to vapor without coming to the liquid form. So here sublimation takes place. So evaporation, transpiration, then interception loss and sublimation, all these processes takes place. Then after going to the atmosphere, here water storage in the atmosphere, that means condensation takes place, and the after the condensation, precipitation takes place, where the water again comes back to the earth in the form of rain and getting stored in the different forms like fresh water in the ocean, spring, infiltration, so all this ground water. So this is our continuous movement of water. First of all, from the ground, from the surface or from the water bodies, many all the water bodies like river, lake, oceans, fresh water, our surface water. So all are getting evaporated, even human body also losing some water, plants body are also losing some water. This is transpiration. The polar caps and glaciers, they are also losing water, that is in the form of sublimation. So all these waters are getting evaporated and going to the atmosphere. After going to the atmosphere, the water vapor cool down, that is called condensation. After cooling down, that is called condensation. And after precipitation takes place, again after precipitation, the water comes back to the earth. So the water continuously move on the earth, and this is called the continuous movement of water, that is called water cycle. That is called water cycle. So since how much water we are using, that much water is coming back to the earth in the form of rain. So that is why it is also considered as renewable resource. Water is very important for us. If we will see the uses of water, it is very important. Without water, we can't imagine our life. We need water for everything we do. So some of the uses of water which are very important, these are for living organisms. Water is very important for domestic purpose also. We need water for farming, we need water for industries, we need water for electricity also, water is needed. So we will discuss all the uses of water bit by bit. If we will see for the living organisms, all the living organisms contain water in their bodies, and they need water for various metabolic processes. We all need water, and even human bodies, about 70% of the human body is composed of water. So it is present in blood and other cell liquids. So water is needed for functioning of all the systems of the body, for various metabolic processes. For everything, water is required by all the living organisms. An average adult should drink about 2 to 3 liters of water every day. So you must drink about 2 to 3 liters of water every day. So next is our domestic purpose. So water is needed for domestic purpose also. It is needed for doing various household works like cooking, washing, cleaning. People get this water from government water distribution system, and some people also use underground water for all these works. So some are getting water from the government's water distribution system, and some are using underground water for various domestic purposes like doing household works, cooking, washing, cleaning the clothes, taking baths. So for everything we need water. For farming, water is very important. Farmers need large amount of water for growing the crops around the year. So this water comes from the rains and from the man-made irrigation system. Earlier the farmers, they were depending completely on the rain for their crops, but nowadays different man-made irrigation systems are there, so that also helps the farmers to grow their crops. Plants need the water to do the photosynthesis and grow. So without water, the plants cannot grow, and we will not be able to grow the crops. So that is why water is very important for farming, and nowadays farmers are also getting water for their crops. Earlier they were depending on the rains, but nowadays different man-made irrigation systems are available. In industries also, water is used in all the industries. It is used for various purposes like raw material. As a raw material, it is used solvent, as a cooling agent and cleaning agent it is used. For electricity, we need water because hydroelectricity is the main source of electricity in most of the parts of the world. And for hydroelectricity, we need water to generate the electricity. That is why water is very important for us. And these are the various uses of water. So now you have to learn the uses of water and the distribution system of the water. So next class, we will discuss about the availability and shortage of the water.